This video is made possible by the following sponsors. Make sure to check out their awesome products in the links below. Hey guys, Jimmy here, and welcome back to F1 2017 for another video. Now today, like a lot of F1 fans, I was left quite disappointed by the qualifying session at Monza. For those who don't know, the session was red flagged due to the amount of rain on the circuit, and partly due, of course, to Grosjean binning it in a straight line. Now, I'm not one of those people that believe F1 drivers should be risking their life for our benefit, but I am one of those people that believe that rain is part of the weekend. If your car can't deal with it, if the tires can't deal with it, then changes need to be made so they can. So what I'm going to do today to hopefully alleviate my boredom with the session of F1 and your guys as well, is do a 25% race around Monza in the pouring rain. So for this video, I'm going to drive as everybody's favourite Formula 1 meme. That's right, it is Jolyon Palmer. And we'll be doing a one-shot qualifying session in the rain, of course, to see where we end up on the grid. Hopefully, I can put on a better show than the real-life F1 did today. Right then, so just about to start our one-shot qualifying here at Monza. You can hear the rain pounding down in the background. But I wanted just to make a couple of things clear so this video doesn't get off on the wrong foot. I am very much aware of the skill and talent it takes to drive these cars in dry conditions in the real world, let alone in wet conditions. Every driver on the grid, including our glorious meme Jolyon Palmer, is 100,000 times more competent than I am in a real car, so I am not competent in their skill at all. I am very much aware of my ability as an armchair sim racer. My frustration lies purely as a fan. I want to see a show. 20 years ago, they'll be going out there on wet tires, monsoon tires, putting on a good show for us. It just feels a little bit less spectacular when there's a drop of rain, the cars get brought in, and that session's had and done. But you guys aren't here to hear me rant, you're here to see me drive, so let's get into it. Okay then, just queuing up then for our qualifying lap on board and in the Renault as old Jay Palmer. You have control of the car now, to make sure we're on max mix. Yes, we are. No, ninth gear, 11th for ninth, looking for my braking zone. I'm going to say about here. Quite hard to judge braking zone in the wet, especially in qualifying trim. Try and get a good run through the first chicane. All the lock I can get on there. Ah, a little bit sideways on exit. Also, wolf spin there, you can see the ghost of Hamilton, who is the current pole lap. We aren't too far off him at the moment, which is nice. We haven't quite got the power on the other cars. Of course, Renault's a little bit down on power compared to the other cars, but we'll deal with it around here. Again, brake as late as I really dare to. A bit early in the brakes there, actually. Third gear on the way in. Rear end trying to slide around. Oh, very slow through there. All that error there came on the entry to the corner. First Lesmo, again, understeer on entry, losing more and more time to our pole set with Hamilton. I do expect that, but not quite at this rate. Again, another locking of the tyre there on the inside. It's a bit too hectic on the brakes. Up the back straight now again. What's that speed there in the bottom left-hand corner? We're topping nearly 200 miles an hour in wet conditions before braking for a scurry. There it is. Getting a bit of a lock as well. Fifth gear on the way through just to keep the gear high. Easy, easy. And then on the throttle, full throttle on the exit there, you can see that Hamilton, the ghost, is absolutely stomping me. No way I can catch up with him through here. My talent doesn't quite allow me to do that. Parabolica. Trying to get a tighter line there, trying to follow the parts of the track where there isn't standing water. Ugh, a bit loose there. Not the best qualifying time. 32 from Hamilton, and it's going to be a 34.7 from us, which is going to put us P16 on the grid. Confirmation of the grid then, with Hamilton pole on a 32.4, narrowly edging out Sebastian Vettel on a 32.5. Scroll down the grid, we can see Nico Hülkenberg, our teammate, on a 34.1. 11th place, we weren't too far off him, 34.7, 6 tenths off there. 16th in the Renault, let's see what we can do come race day. Well, I'm sitting on the grid at Monza in the pouring rain. My Renault mechanics don't seem to care that it's raining, rocking the polo shirts like absolute champs. We're starting from 16th place on the grid on the inside, so that'll be good for T1, of course. Got to be very careful braking to T1, there's going to be a lot of spray, so I'm going to try and just be cautious for the first lap, see how the track is in terms of the grip, and then push on from there. On board in our Renault then, on a very wet Monza grid, waiting for the lights to go. 5 lights and away we go for 13 laps at Monza. Second gear, third, fourth, fifth. I can barely see where I'm going. There's spray all over the place. Trying to look for my marker down to T1. This one 54. I'm going to brake. Oh, brake very late down to T1. Just trying to get it slowed down. I've got to let Stroll take his line there. We're able to run out of room very quickly now on the outside for T2. Trying to find some power there. contact behind me, come on. Oh, wiggling all over the shop. Car is very slippy in these conditions, as you would expect. Cold tyres right now. Stroll in front, looks like Wehrlein behind us in the Sauber. Coming down to second chicane now, brake earlier than I usually would, just trying to find the sweet spot right now on these tyres in these conditions. Not much of a dry line yet. Carlos Sainz disqualified, that's cool enough, I'm not quite sure what he did. First Lesmo trying to follow in the wheel tracks of the car in front. I can barely see where I'm putting the car. Big kick of oversteer there on exit. Bit too liberal of the old throttle application. Second Lesmo, important to get that right for the big straight now coming up to Ascari. Just going to try and follow in the wheel tracks of Stroll. Not quite close enough to make a move here, so I'm going to break a bit earlier again just so I don't run into the back of anyone. Fourth gear through Ascari now, nice and soft, try and straight line as much as possible, try and get that downforce working, try not to slide on the curb there, nearly lost it, curb super slippery in the wet as they would be in real life. Eighth gear, Stroll in front, pulling away a tiny bit, coming up to Parabolica, late on the brakes there, trying to bring that gap back down. Prozon, Perez and Grosjean in front of us. Prozon sounds like some sort of ointment. One lap completed here, nice gap to Wehrlein behind, so not to worry about that. Stroll in front, our aim now I guess is to try and get into the top 10, try and get into those points again, looking for our braking marker just before the 150 for me. Second gear through the first chicane, very careful on the front on the second gear, lots of torque, lots of power there. So early change to third, there you go, nice out of there. Made up a lot of time on Stroll. I'm actually going to rich mix here and see if we can get him before the second chicane. That Williams mighty in a straight line, that Mercedes engine, but we're still pulling in the toe and the Ritz mixture down to standard, not quite close enough there. But I can see maybe for another lap time I can attack there. They've made some progress. Bit slide out second chicane there. Again, a good run out of there, but not any room to get by before the first Lesmo. Trying to avoid that curve, trying not to do a Hamilton. Bringing in nicely, okay, softly, hitting the throttle big time on the curb. Just about keeping it alive. Got to be wary of his tyres as well, they do heat up fairly quickly, so going to pull offline every now and then just to give him a splash of water to cool him down a little bit. Easy through here, come on Jimmy, soft. Trying to be nice and tentative on the throttle through here. Very easy to get the car sideways as you're seeing. Just still within reach of Stroll. Not quite sure where I'm going to be able to make the move. Got Magnussen behind us in a Haas. Hey, Haas! Trying not to be so jabby at the throttle, but I'm failing. Trying not to hit that tarmac on the left there. That little artificial grass is so slippy. It seems like there's some kind of problem with the car. Oh, problem with Ocon. I think he's behind us, though, so it doesn't really affect us. Not right now, anyway. See Stroll still in front of us. Braking a bit too early there. I got a bit mixed up before I was braking. I think it's awkward in front of Perez, so maybe this is going to affect us. I tell a lie. Just standing on the front out of there, the rear end squirming for grip, eventually finding it, assisted by downforce, of course. Such a cool sensation. Even though I'm not in VR right now, the weather effects in F1 are so cool. I really like them here. Ocon is just holding us all up here. Not quite sure what his problem is, but maybe a chance for us to squeeze by while other cars are trying to negotiate their way around him. Let's look how slow we are through here. Got a caution, we've got a yellow flag. I'm not quite sure what that's for. We're going to find out in a second. Vettel out of the race. So Vettel's had an incident. Not quite sure what happened to him there, but that's another place for us. That'll put us up into P11, which means that now Stroll is going to be our fight for the points. Although once Ocon is dealt with, he should hope that'll be us in the points there. There's Ocon on the outside there. Perez trying to find his way around his teammate. Perez and Ocon are contractually obligated to have a crash each race. Good run out of there on Stroll. Go to Rich Mix. Try and make the best of a situation. Grosjean there looking to get past Ocon as well. It's an Ocon train right now as we slow right down the Parabolica side by side with Stroll. Not much room on the inside hip. No, Ocon, don't block me, mate. Heading to the wet line. So slippy here. So slippy! Okay, we're past, I think. Where is Stroll? We're past Ocon. Nice! Up to P9. So we made the best of that situation there. Got around there a little better than Stroll did. Gained a couple of places. Now, let's focus on what's in front of us. Looking in my mirrors to see where Stroll is. Good. Not far enough, or close enough to make an attempt on the position. Perez and Grosjean now in front. Fourth, fifth gear. Sith gear, so quick through the gearbox here. I really enjoy having these paddle shifters back, I can tell you that now. Up to 8th gear, watch that speeder though, up to 190 miles an hour in the wet before breaking down to a very slow chicane, just about getting the car slowed down. Oh, on the curbs big time, you can hear the force feedback rumble. I can definitely feel it in my spine. It's a very powerful force feedback on this OSW, even on only 25%. Definitely can do some serious damage if you aren't careful. Second Lesmo again, need to really focus on getting a better exit out of there, because you carry the mistake all the way down to Ascari if you get it wrong. You can probably just see how much I'm sweating right now, how much effort I have to put in to drive this car fast in the wet and just concentrate at the same time. I know it's not quite the real thing, I know I'm not using as much effort as the real drivers, but this is still definitely exercise, I can tell you that right now. Stroll is still with us though, still in the background, you can see on the minimap, or maybe you can't because my face is covering it up, but I can tell you he's still with us. He put a timing split as well when we go across the line. Top left hand corner of the screen, want to know how close he is. Perez gets very slow out of there. Has Perez got a problem too? I think he had a mistake going to Parabolica. He's really backed up the Haas of Roman Grosjean. We're going to go into the slipstream now.
Okay, you're in the top 10.
Already getting up to max speed. Force India and of course the Haas very fast in a straight line. Not much I can do there. Sorry. Bit of a punt there. Grosjean actually pushed him past Perez. All right, Roman, I'll take credit for that, mate. No damage, it seems. We're good. Although, oh, I saw out of there. Nowhere for me to go on the throttle. We're going to go to the inside. Just darting around in his mirrors now. He knows I'm there, so he's going to go defensive, I imagine, into the chicane. No, he pulls across. No, he's sort of middling line right now. Can't make the move there. Well defended by Grosjean. We're only on lap 5 of this race. There's been action all the way. Yeah, come on now to the inside. Not quite enough room to do anything into the first Lesmo. And I've actually hindered my entrance there and the exit. Big dab of up out. Oh, no, on the grass. Don't be doing that. You can hear the tyres screech as they try and find some grip. Stroll is still with us in the background, so he is definitely still a threat to us. 8th gear again. Climbing up to nearly 200 miles an hour before we break down slightly uphill into Ascari. Easy, easy now. There you go. 5th gear. Straight line as much as we can. Ooh, a little bit cheeky on the exit there. It's so slippy out there. The game definitely punches you from running that wide. We are on the standard mix. Good. I'm sort of keeping that in reserve. We've got a couple of laps of effort. I don't want to show my hand too early because bear in mind, once I'm in front, I'm the one giving the tow. And the Renault engine compared to the Ferrari and the, I think it's a Mercedes in the Force India. I can't actually remember. But those engines are better than the old Renault. So I've got to really take that into account when thinking about overtaking. Saying that, I've got Mercedes only half a second behind me, that is Stroll. It's a Mercedes engine, the Williams. So I've got to keep that in account as well. Easy now, come on, third, fourth, trying to get decent traction. You can see the car just squirming. Such a cool experience this. Of course, the wet weather in this isn't quite the same as real life. You see, I'm going through paddles now, I'm not getting any aquaplaning, just doing that to cool the tyres down a little bit. But in real life, of course, if I did that, I'll just get aquaplaning and go off. Aquaplaning is when you basically just skid across the top of the water and you're basically a passenger at that point. So that isn't quite simulated in the game, but the idea of the being on edge, oh, there it is. That simulated really well. At any corner, I could get the braking wrong, get the throttle a bit too early and the car will spin, or I'll just go straight along the brakes. So I've got to keep 100% concentration at the time, which I'm not doing right now because I'm just yabbering away. But you get the idea. It's definitely a difficult and challenging experience, especially with no assists on, of course, running with no assists at all. 100% AI, still getting used to how they are right now, so they'll probably go up in time, but it's a great challenge so far and I'm really enjoying it. Yellow flag ahead, who's that for? Can't see it for. I think someone spun at the Parabolica.
Green flag.
Yeah, green flag now, so that's been and gone. That could have been another place for us. We're still in P9 though. There are points, more points. We have a big old drifto coming out of Parabolica. Gonna whack it on the rich mix for now because I'm sort of in a bit of no man's land here, falling a little bit further back in Grosjean. Yellow flag again. Someone out? Someone crashed or something? I think there's... Oh, Stroll! Stroll, that distracted me there as I ran into the back of Grosjean. Sorry, dude. So, GG me. So, no more Stroll. Stroll had a, I guess, a blob or something behind us. And during that, other than tobacco corrosion, so our front ring is now damaged to add to the drama. So we can have a little bit less bite at the front now. Our braking capability is going to be a tiny bit less as well, because less downforce slowing us down. But saying that, in a straight line, we're going to be a little bit quicker. I feel like I can maybe make something work that lets one of them a bit closer than that. That's not close enough, though. I can feel the front ploughing a little bit now, so that damage maybe coming to play. It's not too bad. I think it's manageable. Of course, I prefer to keep my rear wing, though. My front wing, sorry. Definitely my rear wing. I definitely want that. But Magnussen now sucked my balls. It's right up behind me, so got to keep an eye on where he is. Heavy braking. You see the tyres, brakes locking slightly as that downforce that was there last lap is now gone. But now I've got a bit of an advantage in a straight line, hopefully. Hopefully that that end plate or whatever it is I lost isn't creating more drag. Hopefully we're getting a little bit more a bit slippy in a straight line now. Which around Monza isn't actually a bad idea, I suppose, running less wing, but not doing it that way. Okay. So Verstappen ahead as well. This could be interesting. This could give us some even more points. I've got to really keep an eye on Magnussen. He's about the same gap to me as I am to Grosjean. I'm running the rich mix for that reason, just trying to make sure he doesn't get any closer, checking the mirrors quickly in the braking zone. Grosjean having to go at Perez, slowing us all up. Trying to find some traction on the exit of the corner. They're not doing a good job by running in the wet bit, but seemed to find a bit of traction there. Grosjean a little bit slow in front, going to take the slipstream. Is he going to defend? They're going to go to the outside, the Curva Grande, then to the inside. No, he's weaving all over the shot. Can we get him done into the chicane? Yes, we can. Nice. Overtake up into P8 there. That was a little bit scary doing that. Grosjean sort of just sat in the middle of the road and made me really look for the gap. But I found it in the end. So up to P8, and now Perez is next for P7. And potentially, Verstappen's got a problem in front. I assume he's in front anyway. This could be a P6 finish, but I won't get ahead of ourselves. We've still got 4.5 laps to go at this point. Was it 5.5? We still have laps to go is what I'm getting to. That was really bad into there. Of course, Perez now under a little bit less pressure. Might help him more. Double upshift into 6th gear there. That's not what I want. Keeping an eye in my mirrors, just trying to make sure that Grosjean doesn't get any ideas. Now, well, he's a good run out of Parabolica, because otherwise I'm going to be a sitting duck on the straight. Of course, again, in this Renault versus Ferrari engine now. Then I might get up to Ritz Mix just to make sure. Okay, he's about 6 tenths back. We should be okay. Still put it on Ritz Mix though, and now braking as late as I really dare to. Car isn't too difficult to slow down with this wing damage. I thought it'd be a lot worse than it is, but it's actually not too bad. Okay, traction out of there. We gained a little bit on Perez through the first chicane. I think the AI just a little bit slow through there in the setting. Or maybe I'm just brilliant. It's definitely not that. You can see a couple of AI cars slowing down in front. I think that might be Verstappen and whoever he's holding up. Nice run there through the second chicane. Gained a lot of time on Perez through there. And then we throw it all the way at the first test mode by just ploughing through the front, refusing to grip. Just me trying to take too much speed through the corner. A lot better through the second test mode. Can the exit be good as well? Okay, not bad. When I come out of Ascari, I'm going to put up to Rich Mix and try and get close to that Mercedes-powered Force India in front. Come on now, easy through there. Good. Fourth gear, fifth gear. Onto the high mix. Grosjean is actually right with me as well. You can't quite see him in the mirror. Well, on the minimap, he's about the same distance to me as I am to Perez. Nice and clean into there, but run over the curb on the inside. That would have lost us about a tenth or so. Oh no, onto the slippery stuff on the exit. That's going to hamper us. Now it's going to allow Grosjean to have a go. I'm going to go defensive straight away. There comes Grosjean. You can see the mirror just coming over to the left. There's the arrow to reinforce. Grosjean blasting past me. I'm going to take a little bit of slipstream. Pull back out again. As late on the brakes as I can be. Refusing to give that place up. A little bit of contact from behind. More contact as Grosjean pushes me round. You little shitter. Oh, okay. Damn it. Ripped by Grosjean there. It's okay though. The car is still one piece. P12. Damn it. We're on for points. It's okay, the points are not over yet. We can get onto the back of this train and hopefully get back into the top 10. Guys in front are fighting as well. That's Hulkenberg. I think Kvyat. So they need to slow each other down so I can get there. Come on, Hulk, fight him. Ah, so annoyed with that. Damn, Grosjean. Just pushed me around. He was side by side. Wasn't happy that I got past him there. It was a bit of a late move, but I was ahead. Grosjean had other ideas. Now I'm out of the slipstream as well, which is really bad around Monza. Alright, okay. Focus. We've lost a lot of time. We have a good couple of laps. We can get onto the back of this train and maybe do something. He says that and I just completely... Sorry about that, Charlie! Missed my turn in, mate. Don't worry about it. This is what's happened. This is what happened in my career mode. I made a mistake and started cutting corners. Shh, tell no one. Right. Guys in front fighting a little bit. Gonna whack it up to a rich mix on the straight again. Just try and negate not having... Having that show again, a little bit slippy there, nearly ran it wide. So Hulk in front, Kvyat in front, Wehrlein behind, but he's way behind. We've got 2.5 seconds to gain here. I think that's possible. We've only got a couple laps to do it in though, so it's got to be a good couple laps from us. Including a good T1, please. Not bad. Oh my god. Jimmy! The bottle is real, come on! Don't know what happened there, just turning in the completely the wrong point. Maybe the tyre's starting to get a little bit warm now. Maybe I'm just getting a little bit flustered. I'm going to just pull onto the off the line there, I should say, to cool the tyres down slightly. Yeah, lost about a second there doing that. And now I just can't get the car slowed down at all. Come on, Jimmy. Ah, what a frustrating end to the race. I wanted points, damn it. Jojo denied again. Yeah, I feel like I've really overheated the tyres. They're really not responding now. I know the tyres do go off towards the end of this race, but I'm really struggling on them right now. Oh man, that's annoying. I was really looking forward to a good finish. Oh, we'll leave it on high mix. We've got enough fuel. Easy now. See that I'm really having trouble getting the car just turned in. Oh, it's slippy on the exit. I tell you that now. So it's like Hulkenberg and Kvyat again are going to be going side by side, this time into the Parabolica. Come on. Come on, Jimmy.
There's 3 laps of fuel remaining.
Ah, shut up, Jeff! Come on! 3.6 seconds. It's just increasing. That's a shame. I think I burned the tyres too much at the start there, pushing. Easy through there this time. I seem to be a lot more efficient doing it that way. Feel like I do have good speed, but I think I just worked the tyres a bit too hard. They overheated a little bit towards the end there, and I got a little bit flustered, made a couple of mistakes as well. That didn't help. Looks like Hulkenberg is really struggling to fend off Kvyat and that Toro Rosso. And again, I just absolutely plow it into the first Lesmo, ruining my exit there. Second Lesmo, let's be a bit better, please. That's a bit better, that'll do. Now they're going to be a bit too far away for me to catch, I think. But hopefully this race for you guys was entertaining. I actually really like driving in the wet in Formula 1 2017. I think it makes a lot of sense. Really entertaining. You feel like you're always treading a very fine line between being on the limit and being in the wall. And in a sense of immersion, that is fantastic. I really enjoy that. I'm starting to gain a bit of time now, but it's a little bit too late. The mistakes I made cost me more. Speaking of mistakes. Oh, I see the tyres. I think I'm really starting to struggle now. I'm going to run offline a little bit here just to gain a little bit of, score off a bit of temperature. 3.5 seconds to Kvyat. So nothing's going to happen in front unless there is an incident. No, I won't be able to catch up unless that happens. Right on the curb there, you can hear the force feedback. Just goes through my entire body. I love it. I'm mashing the throttle there. Just out for a bit of fun this last lap now. I hope you guys found this more interesting than the real-life qualifying session at Monza. It's an all-fest of watching Williams mechanics play football. Not quite what I tuned into F1 for, but all right, Sky. Do what you want, mate. See, at this point in the race, if I was doing career mode, I'd just turn everything down and try and save components, but I'm not. That's sort of the fun of doing these short races. You can really just throw caution to the wind. Saying that, and then you messed up a second Lesmo, sort of dipped there, but it looks like, well, Hamilton's won it. I think that Hülkenberg is going to be able to fend off Kvyat. Really upset that we got caught up in that little incident there at the start. Could have been, the Grosjean punted us. Really could have been a really fun end of the race there, but Labaguette had to ruin it for us. Oh man, I am gaining on them as well. It's just not going to be enough. We'll have a good go into Parabolica anyway. Guys in front are line astern. Looks like Hülkenberg can be able to hold off Kvyat for the line anyway, just watching the position that they are. Yeah, looks like he's got them. So Hülkenberg finishes in the points at least. So 1 point for us. We come home in P12. Not ideal, but that's that. And the game struggles to find out my position there. But there you go, guys. There was a wet race at Monza, showing the F1 guys how to do it. Hamilton wins it. So Toto Wolff, yes, good. Yes, good win. Low detail here becomes high detail. Hope you guys enjoyed that. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. If you really enjoyed it, hit subscribe to be notified of future videos. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day. See you all next time. Oh, I forgot. Here are the actual results. Lewis wins, Bottas second, Raikkonen third, our teammate 10th, and we come home in 12th place, just outside the points, true Palmer style.